Karnataka assembly election results have come. The Narendra Modi-led Bharatiya Janata Party has managed to cross the Rubicon. They have managed to get close to the majority. Maybe by evening they will consolidate on the majority and form the government, as their chief ministerial candidate B.S. Yediyurappa has been saying on 17th of May. In fact, a few days back, rather yesterday, he had said, I can give you in writing that I would be becoming chief minister on 17th of May. Now, with these results out, there is no place for the Congress, there is no chance for the Congress, and there is no chance for the Janata Dal secular to play the kingmaker. The votes which have been counted have given a clear majority to BJP. Now, this clear majority to BJP has not been possible because of any change in the support base of either of the two outfits, or rather the three outfits. What the BJP has done in past 6 months under the leadership of its party president Amit Shah is to consolidate on all its supporters. In first, it went on to announce the name of B.S. Yediyurappa, their biggest mass leader, the leader of the Lingayat community, as its chief ministerial candidate. Having done that, it went ahead and risked its name, its good name, its prestige in getting on board the Reddy brothers of Bellary. It had to ensure that everybody who were or who are supporters of the BJP were with the party in its campaign in South India. They mobilized services of, you know, despite a lot of criticism, they mobilized services of Uttar Pradesh Chief Minister Yogi Adityanath to influence the people belonging to his community, and he was fairly successful at that. In fact, the success of Yogi Adityanath's campaign in Karnataka could be seen from the fact that outgoing CM Siddaramaiah of Congress was tweeting constantly that this man is campaigning in Karnataka, whereas this storm is playing havoc back home in Uttar Pradesh, where he should be. Anyways, if we look back at the whole campaign, it's very, very clear that BJP has proved itself to be a better election machinery, a better poll machinery than the Congress has been. The BJP has mobilized its cadres to the maximum. The BJP has reached to the leaders to the maximum, and it has yielded results for them. As the results show, it's not a very huge victory. Rather, they have been able to get less number of seats than what they have got in 2008 elections. But it's important that despite 4 years of anti-incumbency of Modi government, Modi-led campaign has succeeded in the southern state, and it should lay the what you call foundation stone for their campaigns ahead in Madhya Pradesh, Chhattisgarh, Rajasthan, and 2019 Lok Sabha elections. Thank you so much.